Hello, welcome to the class. My name is Partho Majumdar. Without any further delay, let's get started. Earlier in the course, we discussed many techniques for making predictions on time series data. We saw that each of the techniques produced a lot of outputs. We also discussed what those outputs meant and in brief touched upon what is the implication of those outputs. However, those outputs need to be studied in little bit more details and a little theoretical background of the same can help making better decisions. In this series of bonus lectures, we discuss those outputs in little bit more details, both from a theoretical and practical point of view. I start this discussion series with a discussion on degrees of freedom. First, let's go through some definitions of degrees of freedom. Generically, degrees of freedom is required in any physical modeling. It is the number of independent ways by which a dynamic system can move without violating any constraint imposed on it. In other words, degree of freedom is the minimum number of independent coordinates that can specify the position of a system completely. Let us look at the mathematical definition of the same. In statistics, the number of degrees of freedom is the number of values in the final calculation of the statistic that are free to vary. In general, the degrees of freedom of an estimate of a parameter are equal to the number of independent scores that go into the estimate minus the number of parameters used as intermediary steps in the estimation of the parameter itself. This will become clear through an example. Most of the time, the sample variance has a n minus 1 degrees of freedom. It is computed from n random scores minus one parameter estimated as an intermediate step, which is the sample mean. Let us understand this through an illustration. We know that the formula for sample variance is sigma xi minus x hat, where x hat is the mean of the sample whole squared divided by n minus 1. So as we stated, the S square is the sample variance and X hat is the sample mean. From this formula, it is clear that to calculate the sample variance, the sample mean has to be known. Suppose that n is equal to 5 and sample mean is equal to 20. Then we know that the summation of all xi's is equal to 20 into 5 or equal to 100. Now if we vary x1, x2, x3, x4, then x5 has to be 100 minus x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4, because x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 has to equal 100. So we can vary 4 variables, or in other words, the degrees of freedom is 5 minus 1 is equal to 4, which is n minus 1. Thank you for listening.